Hello, my siblings in Christ, I'm Boyan, and welcome to Hell yet again. Eternal Hell. Also, welcome to my new series, Wrath of God, where we will, God willing, discuss such interesting subjects as the nature of hell, penal substitution, predestination, and so forth. Today we will talk about the eternity of hell. Eternal hell is a scary concept. Some people leave Christianity because they can't digest it. Others simply turn to heresy, annihilationism, or its extreme opposite, apokatastasis. Now, God does not utterly destroy sinners. Suffice to say, God does not create in order to destroy. This leaves us with apokatastasis, the favorite heresy of many. I don't blame them, it is a tempting one. Simply put, the apokatastasis is a teaching according to which, in the end, everyone will be saved. Not just humans, but demons as well. It is a pretty and tempting teaching. In the Orthodox Church, the teaching has been condemned as heretical, and for a good reason. It is okay to hope that, in the end, all will say yes to God. But it becomes a big issue if you think that absolutely everyone will say yes to God. Furthermore, I believe that those who are in hell cannot repent out of the reason that their repentance wouldn't be sincere. They would repent only as far as to escape their torments. There is a story from Dostoevsky that shows this superbly. I'll paraphrase it. In this village there lived a certain evil woman. She had absolutely no good deeds. She lied, cheated, stole, cursed, did magic, and so on. She died and was consigned to hell. Her guardian angel approached the Lord and asked if there's a chance for her to be saved. The other angel jumped in. She had no good deed. Her guardian angel replies, nah, she fed a hungry man once. And the other angel say, no, she threw an onion at a beggar when he asks for some food. She wanted him to get out of her face. But the guardian angel is smart and he says, see, even a good deed done in spite is still an act of kindness in the Lord's eyes. The Lord is, by this point, bored with his beloved angel's bickering, so he tells the guardian angel to dip said onion into hell and try to pull out the woman out of it. The guardian angel does so, and the woman, seeing the onion, immediately grabs it. However, other damned souls all flock to the onion and grab it as well. The guardian angel begins to pull, but the woman starts kicking and screaming, this is my onion, I gave it, you can't have it, as she tries to kick other souls away from the stem. As soon as she says that, the stem breaks and she falls into the abyss once again. People can say no forever to God. I don't think that it is much of saying a singular no, but a continuous everlasting no. You may think that no one in their right mind would say no to someone as beautiful and awesome and good as God, but bear in mind that one third of the angels did. We do it on a daily basis even. If you cannot comprehend how love can turn foul, watch War of the Roses, a beautiful love story that turns into scorched earth warfare.